Today I am going to be making a hemp soap. I have some hemp protein powder. I have some hemp seeds. I have some chromium green oxide. I'm going to mix those two together because the hemp powder or the hemp protein doesn't look too pretty. Over here I have my oils, and I will show you what my recipe is right here. Okay, so these are all of my oils, and I've already put a little bit of kale and clay in there, and that's it. The kind of greenish color is from the hemp oil. So I'm hoping, I'm going to add a little bit of titanium dioxide. I want to kind of have two colors. I'm going to do an in the pot swirl with a hanger swirl. And I was going to get all complicated, however, the recipe that I ended up going with is a little... I got a little excited with the additives, so I'm going to keep it nice and simple with an in the pot swirl combined with a hanger swirl. Now my oils and my lye water are all at the same temperature. I'm going to go ahead and slowly combine them. And by the way, this little stainless steel pot is awesome. I really like it. It's a Mr. Coffee. It's actually a frothing pitcher. I think it's 32 ounces, but it's stainless steel, and I like it. And now I can't decide if I want a in-the-pot swirl or a drop swirl, and I'm thinking I might change my mind and go with the drop swirl. And I always do that. I have a plan, and then I get excited about something else, so we'll see. Now in this container, in this one, I have 2 ounces of coconut milk, I have my fragrance oil mix, and also some oat extract. And that's the reason why I'm soaping lower, is because of the coconut milk. I want to do a half and half. It doesn't have to be exact. Ish? Nope. A little bit more. I am like the messiest pouring person ever. Okay, now that's my titanium dioxide, which I've already run through a tea strainer. And in this other one, I'm going to add my hemp protein powder, which is an ugly, ugly green. So I'm gonna pump it up with some chromium green oxide. And I'm gonna have to mix this one really well so I don't get chunkies in it. And be sure to scrape the sides and especially the bottom, because that's where the colorant always seems to go. Some little specks in there, and that looks like it's from the protein powder, so I'm just going to embrace it. I'm going to go rinse off my stick blender. Okay, and there's that. Now the fragrance that I mixed up is a combination of cannabis rose and a little bit of that patchouli. Now, I was pleasantly surprised by how good the cannabis rose smelled when I smelled it, but I wanted to kind of have that hippie spirit almost. Okay, I want this to thicken up before I do my drop swirl. You see, I got some air bubbles in there too. So now this is perfect for a drop swirl. So not an in the pot swirl, drop swirl with hanger swirl. Switching it up. A nice pretty green. Oh, I love the specks in there. There are pretty little specks from the protein powder. Let's see, I already blobbed it. Makes such a mess. Switch sides. Oops. Not so good with my left hand. Yeah, I'm gonna have to pour right-handed. Nice, this recipe does give you a lot of working time. Okay. And this last part I'm not really drop swirling, I'm just kind of putting it down the middle. Okay, now I'm going to do my hanger swirl. All right, now I'm going to do the top. My rooster's still going crazy, I'm telling you. That guy is nuts. Just kind of pushing the white to the edges. It doesn't have to go all the way because I'm going to use a spoon to kind of mix it up. But I definitely want the middle to be all white. That's a little fluid, so I think I'll just do the other side, and then I'll come back and retexture it once it's set up just a little bit, because this is more fluid and I wanted more defined. So I'm going to leave it, and I'm going to, in the meantime, I'm going to clean my messy dishes. So it sat for a while. I actually had the opportunity to do all of my soaping dishes and clean my kitchen. This recipe will give you a lot of time to work. I don't know if I've ever finished a soap and had no dishes to clean up afterwards, which is usually like the worst part of soaping. I just like to go along the sides, kind of get a mohawk down the middle, and then I'll swoosh it. Hold on to anything when I'm wearing gloves. I just have butterfingers. So when I sprinkle the seeds, I'm going barehanded. However, I recommend you keep your gloves on. This is a do as I say, not as I do moment. I'm just going to sprinkle seeds right down the middle. And I like the colors that the seeds came in. Like some like tan and darker flecks, and it's just, these are pretty seeds. And then spray the top with rubbing alcohol. And there is What the Hemp.